In this video, we'll talk more about emissivity and absorptivity of semi-transparent or opaque material, particularly when can these both be equated. The famous law about the equation equating these emissivity absorptivity is by the German physicist Gustav Kirchhoff, the same Kirchhoff law which you have heard in electrical networks. He was he proposed this theory much before Planck found the distribution of the black body radiation. So what is the problem we have in hand? Consider this is a Kirchhoff law only at equilibrium. We'll show other exceptions. We'll relax these exceptions later. But consider a body, a cavity, completely closed cavity. There is no hole and all. That's completely closed cavity, which is maintained at a temperature TS. Inside this cavity, we have several small objects. Each has got a surface area A1, A2, A3, and so on. Now we know that the inside a cavity, after all reflections and absorptions, whatever is emitted from here is a black body radiation at temperature T. So whatever is emitted here is a black body radiation. And therefore, whatever is emitted, so the only field that is visible here at any region inside is this black body radiation. So the irradiation equals the emission from the surface of the cavity. So this irradiation also is a black body radiation that is incident on the small surfaces. At equilibrium, if you balance the heat flux here, energy that comes through this and energy that goes out from this. Energy that comes through this, which is absorbed, which is alpha 1 times G, which is absorbed. A1 is the area. So this is watts per meter times area. So this is watts. This is rate of energy absorption. Similarly, emission from here is E1 times A1. E1 is the emission of intensity of body one, and multiplied by the area gives the watts, gives the energy in watts, rate of energy radiation in watts. So A1, A1 cuts and we have E1 by alpha 1 equal to G. So E1 by alpha 1 equal to G, and G is nothing but EB into T. EB is a function of the surface temperature, that is the black body emission. So this expression E1 by alpha 1 equal to EB holds good for all the objects there, E2 by alpha 2, E3 by alpha 3, and so on. Therefore, now for body 1, epsilon 1 is the emissivity, which means epsilon 1 is E1, that emissivity of this, divided by emissivity of the black body. Now at equilibrium, we mean that this is all at the same temperature, TS, as the temperature of the surface A. So at equilibrium, everything is at the same temperature. So therefore, epsilon 1 is the emission from the surface, which is E1, by EB, which is the black body thing, black body radiation at the same temperature. So this is true for all the objects. And substituting this here, we get epsilon 1 by alpha 1 equal to epsilon 2 by alpha 2 equal to epsilon 3 by alpha 3, all equal to EB by this EB in this way, EB cuts, and you have equal to 1. So therefore, epsilon by alpha is same for everything and is equal to 1. And we can say that in general, epsilon equal to alpha. So what are the conditions under which this was equal? We had assumed important thing is that it's equilibrium. That is, everything inside the cavity is at equilibrium. So everything is at equilibrium, then the emissivity of this object will be same as the absorptivity of the surface. Now we want to see more general expressions of this. To do that, we recognize this particular identity relation. What it says that spectral directional emissivity equals spectral directional absorptivity. And this relationship holds good irrespective of equilibrium or any surface or anything. This always holds good. Let us see how. So consider an incident radiation G at a given lambda, at a monochromatic lambda is incident on a surface at a given angle. Part of it is transmitted, part of it is absorbed, and say some of it is emitted, reflected. So once the temperature of this object becomes constant, that it's at steady state, whatever is absorbed, that much energy will also be emitted. So what this essentially says is that the fraction of G, which is absorbed, is the fraction which is emitted. Right? So whatever energy you, so if you consider what happens in the atomistic level, radiation is coming at a given direction, at a given wavelength. What is it doing? It is going and exciting electrons from the ground state to some excited state. So this is coming at a particular angle, at a particular lambda. So because of that, electrons in that this photon energy will be converted to the electron energy from its ground state to an excited state of that energy. Now, any electron at that state need not be there continuously. It can spontaneously emit and come down to the ground state. So therefore, it will also be decaying the same quantum of lambda at the same h nu by spontaneous emission and in the same direction. So if there was a surface that's electron that was facing here, this is going to absorb in this, whatever is going to absorb, it is going to emit as well. So therefore, this identity is a property of the substance, of the surface. So it's an inherent property. It does not depend on whether the surface is diffuse or it is dependent on lambda or something. Because we are hitting a monochromatic light, part of it is absorbed. Whatever is absorbed comes back in the same direction when the electron goes from ground state to excited state and back. So using this identity, this is the most general thing, but this is not very useful in an engineering context, whereas the Kirchhoff law was very useful. But we need to understand from here, how do we get to the Kirchhoff law? So to summarize, we have three levels. Firstly, this one, which is that the spectral and directional emissivity equals the spectral and directional absorptivity at all conditions without any restriction. Then there you can have one restriction that when will spectral emissivity equal to the spectral absorptivity. So when the surface is diffuse, then the theta variation goes away and we have only spectral dependence, even if they are at different temperatures. Then another approximation, which is the Kirchhoff's law, is that it is not only that the temperature, not only that the surface is diffuse, but also it has to be what is called as a gray surface. So we'll see the derivations of these both equations in the next slide. Firstly, let us see the equivalence of spectral emissivity to spectral absorptivity. To see that, let's see the definitions of spectral emissivity and spectral absorptivity. Spectral emissivity is nothing but the angle average of the spectral directional emissivity taken over all the hemispherical angles and normalized by the hemispherical angle. Similarly, spectral absorptivity comes from absorptivity times the incident, spectral directional absorptivity times the incident irradiation divided by integral over all possible angles of the incident irradiation. Now, if we want these both to be equal, we need to see what we can equate in these both so that these terms are equal. Remember that we saw that the spectral directional emissivity is always equal to spectral directional absorptivity. Now, this is given. Apart from this, these both terms are appearing here, right? Epsilon lambda theta and alpha lambda theta are appearing here. Apart from this, we have the other terms. So let's see if we can do some make some assumptions so that these both are equal. The first approximation that we'll make is in cases where the incident irradiation, spectral incident radiation, is not a function of direction. That is, the irradiation is diffusive. In which case, this term can be pulled out of the integral in the numerator. Similarly, this term in the integrator in the denominator. And what is remaining is just alpha lambda theta and epsilon lambda theta here. So since alpha lambda theta is epsilon lambda theta, these both are equal. So in this case, where you have irradiation is equal, irradiation is diffusive, you have epsilon lambda is equal to alpha lambda. We can have one more case. If this spectral radiational, spectral directional emissivity equals spectral directional absorptivity, and it is not a function of theta and phi. That is, in a case where this surface, these are all, these both are surface properties. One is talking about the emissivity, which is not direction dependent. Other is talking about the absorptivity, which is not direction dependent. So when the surface is diffusive, then you can pull out this term out of the integral because it's independent of the angles. Similarly, this you can pull out of the integral. In which case, what you will have is a numerator and denominator are identical here as well as here. And since epsilon lambda theta equal to alpha lambda theta, which has been already pulled out, we also can say that the spectral epsilon lambda is same as alpha lambda. So to summarize, epsilon lambda equal to alpha lambda if radiation is diffusive or the surface is diffusive. Let us look at the second case where we are talking about the total equivalence. Total equivalence in the sense epsilon, that is integrated over all the lambdas, equals alpha integrated over all the lambdas. Let's quickly see when this is possible. To do that, we'll again go back to the definition of epsilon and alpha, which is nothing but your epsilon integrated over all the lambdas of epsilon lambda E lambda B, which is the black body irradiation. Similarly, alpha is alpha lambda times G, which is G lambda, which is the spectral irradiation. So these are the definitions, and we want these both terms to, we want to see in what condition that these both can be equated. Now, remember that this will happen only and if this, the previous condition that we saw here holds good. So that is given, if epsilon lambda equal to alpha lambda and a few other conditions in which these both can be equal. Let's see what are they. The first condition is G, which is the irradiation, which is coming into the surface, equals as though it is coming from a body which is at the same temperature, the black body at the same temperature. So if there is an external black body which is at the same temperature and that temperature as the surface, and that is your irradiation. Irradiation is also equivalent coming from a black body at the same temperature. Then this term here can be replaced by EB, right? So this becomes EB, and we know that epsilon lambda is alpha lambda. So then this denominator again becomes EB, which is black body radiation. And therefore this, this integral equals this integral. A second case is possible where we have a gray surface. A gray surface by definition means that this epsilon lambda and alpha lambda are not a function of lambda. So for all lambdas, the emissivity and absorptivity are the same. In such cases, we can see that epsilon lambda can be pulled out of the integral, alpha lambda can be pulled out of the integral, and what is remaining here is nothing but integral 0 to infinity of E lambda, which is nothing but EB. Similarly, integral 0 to infinity of G lambda is nothing but G. So the integral numerator and denominator identically cancels out. What is remaining is simply your epsilon lambda and alpha lambda. So to summarize, the total equivalence of E and alpha, epsilon and alpha, happens if epsilon lambda equal to alpha lambda and one of these two conditions, that the incident radiation is coming from a black body of the same temperature, or the surface is gray, in the sense that emissivity and absorptivity are not functions of lambda.
Let's take a case of a violation. So here is a material where alpha lambda has this behavior as a function of lambda. So up to lambda 1, it is 1, and then it becomes 0. Now consider two irradiation functions. One irradiation function is dominant from 0 to lambda, and then it becomes 0. Other radiation function is 0 from 0 to lambda, and then it becomes dominant. Now, if you calculate alpha 1 for this first irradiation, so the fraction of the first radiation that is absorbed for the first irradiation, so we have to take alpha 1 equal to alpha lambda G lambda 1, that is this one. So between 0 and lambda, alpha is 1. So this is 1, so you can pull it out. So integral 0 to infinity, this one divided by G1 is approximately 1. So for this irradiation, alpha 1 equal to 1. Similarly here, when you do the integral, alpha is 0 here, alpha is 1 here and then becomes 0 here. So here this G2 is multiplied by a number which is 0 throughout, roughly 0 throughout. So effectively alpha 2 is 0. So in this case, alpha 1 is 0, alpha 1 is 1 and alpha 2 is 0. Essentially what we're saying is that alpha 1 and alpha 2 are dependent on the way this distribution alpha is, as well as the irradiation distribution. Whereas epsilon is purely a function of the black body radiation coming from the body. It's not a function of irradiation. This is function of what is incident. This is function of what is emanating. And since this is not a function of what is incident, so there can be situations where in some regions, these both are equal. In some regions, it's not equal at all. So we need to be careful about both this function as well as this function in determining whether we can use Kirchhoff's law or not.
Here's another case where we can use Kirchhoff's law in, even though it is not exactly equal throughout. So here is a case where you have E lambda equal to alpha lambda in a certain region of lambda 1 to lambda 4. So in this region, it is equal, and it equal to some constant E naught and alpha naught. Now suppose we have G lambda, which is zero throughout, and then has some value here, and then becomes zero here. So between zero and lambda 3, it is zero, and after lambda 4, it is zero. E lambda, on the other hand, is zero from zero to lambda 1, and after lambda 3, it is zero. So in this case also, since lambda, since your epsilon and alpha are one in this entire region, and when you multiply this by this, or this by this, effectively it is the same. So your integral balance that we've found here will still be the same. Alpha epsilon 1 times epsilon times E or alpha times G, both will be the same here. So then you can equate them both and then say epsilon lambda is alpha lambda. To summarize, diffuse and gray surfaces are real surfaces in where you can make some approximations, and they are useful, which we'll see in detail radiation calculation, radiation exchange calculation. And to decide whether you can use a diffuse or diffuse or gray surface, it's important to study the spectral distribution of the radiation and emission. Thank you.